Let's have a look at a geometric interpretation of the singular valley decomposition. Well, what do we have here? We have, to give a geometric interpretation, it's a little hard to go beyond R2, two space in reals. And notice that therefore we're going to look at a matrix that's a 2x2 matrix that takes vectors from R2 to R2. And we've already talked a lot about the unit ball. So this here is the unit ball. And how A transforms vectors can be completely described by looking how vectors of unit length are transformed. And typically, if you look at the projection of the unit ball, or the image of the unit ball, it looks elongated like this. And that comes from the fact that you're taking linear combinations and matrix vector multiply preserves the linear transformation, the linear combination. Okay, so in this epidermic case, U would consist of U0, U1. Sigma would consist of sigma 0, sigma 1. And V would consist of V0, V1. Like that. Now, the 2 norm of A would be sigma 0, the largest singular value. And notice that that was the maximal magnification of a unit vector. This is the maximal magnification. Okay? So, this distance right here is really sigma 0 from here to here. Right? Now, in coming up with the singular value decomposition, what did we say? We said, let's pick V0 so that it's the unit vector, unit length vector, such that it achieves the maximum magnification. So what does that mean? That means that over here, there's some vector, V0, that maps to this vector right here. Okay, so this here is A times V0. Okay? Now, we then said, let's pick U0 in that direction, but of length 1. So we could put a unit circle here, but let's just put it right here. Let's say that that's unit length, and that is U0. Okay. We then said, let's fill out U with an orthonormal basis. So what that meant was that we found another vector of unit length, U1, which must be perpendicular, orthogonal. And similarly, we filled out V1 here. Let's say we pick this one right here. Okay, and then actually, this became our submatrix B, and we proved that those had to be 0. So, this is the geometric interpretation. If you now take any vector on the unit circle, that vector can be written as a linear combination of these two vectors. And the vector that that then maps to is the same linear combination of this vector and that vector. As a matter of fact, this vector right here is the vector sigma 1 times U1. Okay, now you can sort of also see what happens if the smallest singular value is actually equal to 0. Then this whole thing would collapse into a line, and that's when the matrix is singular. Why? Because you wouldn't be able to get an inverse function if you started with any vector that was not on that line. we're going to see that it is actually the ratio between this distance and this distance that determines how close to singular a matrix is. Okay? If this is a perfect circle, then you actually end up with a matrix with condition number equal to 1. Those are the good ones. Anyway, there's the picture.